Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this session, I'm going to cover an interesting topic, CSS selectors. Let's see how a selector works. Dollar bracket start bracket end selector. Dollar selector is used to select HTML elements. You select by ID of the HTML elements. You can select by name. You can select by CSS class. You can select by HTML type as well. Even we have alternative selector is jQuery bracket. This alternative selector is used when your dollar is being occupied by some other library. Let's see the example. Tag name, select by name. You pass like this, dollar tag name. Tag ID, you pass like this, dollar hash tag ID. This is important. In case you are using select by ID, make sure you are having hash with it. Otherwise, tag class. You know the class, CSS class of the element, then you can search like this, dollar dot tag hyphen class. Let's see the examples. Here what we are doing. We are having a parent structure like this, dev, parent dev, display none. We have three paragraphs. This is my first paragraph, this is my second paragraph, this is my third paragraph. Done. In another dev, there is a message dev which is empty. Purpose of this exercise is to print these paragraphs within message div. Let's see how to do it. In our code, what we are doing? Where paragraph dollar $p. So we are selecting all paragraphs via this selector. So where paragraph is now an array of all the paragraphs which are present in this particular document. So there are three paragraphs. This is first paragraph, this is second paragraph, and this is third paragraph. So all three are now present in this paragraph variable. Then where temp is empty, for I equals 0, I paragraph dot length, I plus plus, I am simply iterating over the paragraphs. Then getting the inner HTML of each paragraph and putting the temp variable in my message div. Now look at this syntax, dollar hash message div. So I am getting element by ID. So my message div now has this. This is first paragraph, this is second paragraph, this is my third paragraph. So in this exercise, we have seen uses of your tag type P, then you get element by ID. Let's see these examples practically.
In this example, we are covering selectors. So here we have a div, parent div, and three paragraphs, tags. Then in script, we are getting all these paragraphs using dollar $p, which is a selector, so that all paragraphs are getting selected. Now we have array of paragraphs. We are iterating it using for loop and getting the inner HTML of each paragraph in the temp variable. Then we are printing this value in message div. So message div output would be, this is first paragraph, this is second paragraph, this is third paragraph in same line. So let's see and verify the output.